When you hear a Honda guy be like, oh, VTEC, bro, what he's talking about is basically BMW's VANOS system. Us BMW guys just don't brag about VANOS, and BMW doesn't badge their cars with VANOS on it to make it seem like it's really that big of a deal like Honda does with all of their VTEC stuff. No hate to the Honda guides. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Zach is our resident BMW expert. Not to say I'm not a BMW expert, but he tends to do a lot of our BMW videos, but I've written 3 guides on VANOS systems, so I get to be the one to talk to you about VANOS today. VANOS is a relatively complex system that BMW uses, but we're gonna go ahead and break it down for you in simplistic terms. I'll go ahead and talk to you about what VANOS is in an understandable fashion, and then talk to you about the different types of VANOS systems, as well as provide you with some insights on what the symptoms look like for VANOS failure, as well as talk about VANOS replacement options for each different engine and type of VANOS system that there is out there. VANOS is a variable valve timing system wrapped into a fancy term, just like VTEC is for Hondas. What variable valve timing is, variable valve timing basically allows for electronic adjustments to valve timing, which helps create smoother idling, better low-end torque without sacrificing high-end power, a more elastic power band, and overall a better driving experience. So the VANOS system works by using oil pressure to control the position of the intake and exhaust camshafts. There is a VANOS actuator, which has a small gear on it that connects to a gear on both the intake and the exhaust camshaft. An oil pressure controlled solenoid is then used to push this gear outwards and inwards to ultimately control timing of the valves based on the position of the camshaft. At idle, the valve is going to be fully closed, and as you start to accelerate, the solenoid is going to open up, which is going to cause the gear on the actuator system to start pushing outwards, which is going to adjust the position of the camshaft to adjust timing. Hopefully that all makes sense. There are 3 different types of VANOS systems. You have your single VANOS system, which, as the name suggests, it only adjusts timing for the intake camshaft and the intake valves. It does not control timing for the exhaust valves. The second one is dual VANOS, and as you can guess, this is variable valve timing for both the intake and the exhaust valves. And then the third one on the list is dual VANOS with Valvetronic. Now, in 2010 or so, BMW came out with Valvetronic, which is an electronic valve lift adjustment system. The VANOS system was integrated with Valvetronic so that it can provide both variable valve timing as well as variable adjustments to valve lift. So each of these are a bit different. Ultimately, the systems are all the same. The whole point is to provide variable timing adjustments to optimize performance and to optimize drivability. Now, while the way that they all work is relatively similar, there are some different symptoms, different replacement options, and different engine fault codes that you're gonna get when one of them gets bad. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump into each one of the specific VANOS systems here. We'll talk a little bit about the cars that use them, the symptoms and fault code you're gonna get, and what the replacement options look like for it. So the first system is single VANOS, which came out in 1993 and was used up until about 2000 in engines like the M50, the M52, the S52, and the M62. When the VANOS systems go bad on these engines, you're gonna get engine codes for P1519, as well as a number of performance-related issues like a loss of power, decreased drivability, rough idling and rattling noises, and worsened fuel economy. Now, the unfortunate thing with these older VANOS systems and older engines is that it isn't as simple to replace the VANOS units. You either have to replace the full unit or you need to send it into a repair shop and have the VANOS unit be completely rebuilt. This is a little bit more expensive of a problem on these cars, as well as a little bit more challenging to go ahead and repair since the whole unit needs to be replaced. The second system is dual VANOS. This was used from the early 2000s until about 2010 in the N54 engine. It was also used in the M52, the M54, and the S54 as sort of an upgrade to the previous single VANOS that those engines had used. Here you're gonna get quite a few different engine codes. So you get P1520, P1523, and P1397. P1397 is for the camshaft position sensor, but if you replace that and you're still getting problems and getting engine codes, then it's gonna be with the VANOS solenoids. And additionally, you're gonna get 2A82 and 2A87 codes, which indicate that you have bad VANOS solenoids. Also, you're gonna get a lot of the similar performance-related issues like rough idling, lack of acceleration, decreased throttle response, rough idling, slow starts, and you can also get put into limp mode while you're accelerating. Fortunately, with these dual VANOS systems, fixing the problem is a lot easier than the previous single VANOS where you had to completely rebuild the unit. With the dual VANOS, it is primarily the VANOS solenoids that go bad, and the VANOS solenoids are separated from the actual VANOS unit and the VANOS actuators. And so you can simply pull the VANOS solenoids out of the engine and put new VANOS solenoids in without having to pull out the whole VANOS unit and have to rebuild or replace the whole thing. This makes it a little bit easier to fix as well as a lot more cost effective as well. Now, the last one is dual VANOS with Valvetronic. Basically any newer BMW engine from the N55 onwards is going to use this form of VANOS that is integrated with Valvetronic, which is the valve lift system. For this, you're gonna be getting engine codes ranging from P0011 to P0025, as well as 2A7A, 2A99, and then 2A87 and 2A82 as well. Additionally, you're gonna get very similar power and performance related problems like a loss of power, limp mode, cold start issues, rough idling, stalling during idle, and so on. Fortunately here as well, similar to the dual VANOS units, the primary problem on these ones is with the VANOS solenoids, and so you can simply replace the VANOS solenoids to fix the issue without having to pull the whole unit out. Now, with the dual VANOS and dual VANOS with Valvetronic, the problems that you have are pretty much always going to be with the VANOS solenoids rather than with the actuators themselves. I very rarely have ever seen an issue with the actual VANOS unit. It's more so just the solenoids, but it can be a little bit more complicated to diagnose the solenoids if you're not getting any engine codes, because the symptoms that you get from VANOS solenoid failure are very similar to the symptoms that you get from bad spark plugs or bad ignition coils. When it comes to diagnosing VANOS related issues, the most important thing is going to be reading your engine codes and seeing if you have any of these engine codes that I've mentioned here. That's going to be the most surefire way of pinpointing the VANOS solenoids rather than chasing this problem and replacing spark plugs and ignition coils when that doesn't need to happen. If you are just getting generic misfire codes, you can go ahead and try to diagnose your spark plugs and your ignition coils. If it's not those, then there is a very good likelihood that it is the VANOS solenoids. Rather than just replacing them, you can try to pull them from the engine, clean them, and then put them back in. Sometimes they just get gunked up from oil deposits to where it'll impact the flow, which impacts the pressure that's applied on the VANOS actuator and the cam gear in there. And so cleaning the solenoids is probably the best first place to start if you think you have solenoid issues, just because some of these solenoids, especially the genuine BMW ones, are like $300. There are cheaper aftermarket options, but they can get expensive if you go ahead and replace both of the VANOS solenoids, and so cleaning them is a great first step. Anyways, I know I didn't get too deep into the technical functionality of what the VANOS system is. Maybe we can do a future video where I dig a little bit more into the specifics of it with some nice graphs that show you how it functions. But what's probably more important is understanding what the signs and symptoms are of VANOS solenoid failure, because VANOS issues are extremely common on pretty much every vehicle that uses it. It's very similar to spark plugs and ignition coils from a maintenance perspective. meaning your Vano solenoids typically aren't gonna last 150,000 miles without replacing. So it is a good idea to stay on top of the maintenance with them, try cleaning them, and replace them when you start to run into issues. That's it for this video. If you appreciate this content, please subscribe to the channel, click the like button, and stay tuned for future videos.